Every week, the United Kingdom sends £350 million of taxpayers' money to the EU. That's the cost of a fully staffed, brand new hospital. Or looked at another way, that's £20 billion per year. It's the same as half of England's schools budget. Four times Scotland's schools budget. It's four times the UK's science and research budget. And 60 times the money we spend on cancer drugs. Let's imagine what else this money could buy. State-of-the-art hospitals. Hundreds of new schools. Pioneering health and scientific research. We could build new roads and improve the railways. Expand regional airports. And we could lower taxation.
For over 40 years, we've been told lots of things about the EU, but were they true? We were told it was a common market.
But what we have done, I think, is to help change the nature of the market in ways that are going to be helpful for Britain if the British people vote to stay in the market.
But is that what EU politicians are saying now?
Sometimes I like to compare the European Union as a creation to the organization of empires. The empires. Because we have the dimension of empires.
They said we'd keep control of our borders.
There can be no question of lifting our border controls. We are an island, we need them, they're vital.
They said we wouldn't give the EU more money.
The UKB rebate will remain and we will not negotiate it away, period.
They said we wouldn't have to bail out Greece.
Let me be clear, whatever the Commission President says, British taxpayers will not be contributing to the Eurozone's bailout of Greece, yeah. Full stop.
So, should we expect things to be any different now?
If I could get these terms for British membership, I sure would opt in to be a member of the European Union, because these are good terms.
After all, remember who he is dealing with. Don't get conned again. It's safer to take back control and spend our money on our priorities. Vote Leave, take control. David Cameron cannot be trusted on Turkey.
If your vote in this referendum is being influenced by considerations about Turkish membership of the EU, don't think about it. It's not remotely on the cards. It's not an issue in this referendum, and it shouldn't be.
David Cameron now claims Turkey won't join the EU, but that's not what he said before.
This is something I feel very strongly, very passionately about. Together, I want us to pave the road from Ankara to Brussels.
We are giving £2 billion to Macedonia, Serbia, Albania, Montenegro and Turkey to join the EU. You can't trust David Cameron on Turkey. If you want to save the NHS, vote Leave. Let's take back control.
At the end of the war, Britain created the NHS. It protects us throughout our lives.
but it's in danger. You can help it. Every week, we send £350 million to Brussels. Money that's wasted. That's enough to build a new hospital every week. It will get worse. The euro is broken, and the EU plans to let in another five countries. Imagine what will happen when you're paying for the euro bailouts. Imagine what will happen to public services when Albania, Macedonia, Montenegro, Serbia, and Turkey join the EU. Imagine our money being spent on our priorities. You can make this happen. This might be our last chance. So let's take back control. Vote Leave on the 23rd of June.
Isaac Newton is the most influential scientist in world history. He invented modern physics, first discovered the law of gravity, and laid the scientific foundation for the Industrial Revolution. Nelson and Wellington's leadership saved Britain from invasion and saved Europe from Napoleon's tyranny. Florence Nightingale invented modern nursing. Charles Darwin first developed the theory of evolution, revolutionizing our understanding of human history. James Maxwell first wrote the equations that describe electricity, magnetism, and light. Emmeline Pankhurst won women the right to vote. Churchill's leadership saved Britain, Europe, and the world from Nazism. Nye Bevan created the NHS. Alan Turing helped break the Nazis' secret codes, which shortened World War II. His work on modern digital computers is the basis for the information revolution. These British heroes changed the world. Don't believe those who talk Britain down, who say we're too weak to control our own affairs. Let's take control.
Former managing director of Goldman Sachs. Could I just give you the opportunity to refute any suggestion that Goldman Sachs may have put pressure on you to take it?
Yes, I refute it categorically.
Thank you.
our NHS is at breaking point. Every week, the UK pays £350 million to be part of the EU. That's £350 million that could build one new hospital every week. £350 million that could be spent supporting our doctors and nurses. Now is your chance to take back control and spend our money on our priorities like the NHS. Vote Leave on the 23rd of June.
If you correctly predict all the results in the European Football Championship, I'll give you £5.
£5? If I predict the scores?
Just a win or draw.
What are the odds on that? Well, in that case, Kevin, I'll bet you £50.
I'll make it £50,000.
Right, then I'll raise you. £50 million.
£50 million, Gary? That's as much as you give the EU every day.
Well, it's your chance to win it, Kev. You can finally buy that Picasso.
My favourite artist, Gary. And your chance too. It's free to enter. Just fill in the form at 50million.uk. And if you correctly predict all of the outcomes from the European Football Championship this summer, you will win £50 million.
Go to 50million.uk now and you could win £50 million.
You just log on to 50million.uk, click sign up. Here you pick which team wins or whether it's a draw for each game. And that's it. Good luck. Gary, Turkey or Albania?
Well, they're both joining the EU, aren't they?
Yes, I know, but which one do you think will win?
Well, Turkey's got 76 million people, so they should have a good team.
Turkey is in, Gary.
Fancy some quinoa?
Quinoa? I think you mean quinoa, Gary.
I think I prefer chips. Hey, fancy a kickabout?
Gary, mind the late 19th century paintings?
We're multi-millionaires now, Kev. Did you know a member of the European Parliament gets paid £75,000 a year?
How much?
And 45 grand expenses.
Get out. I heard they get €300 a day expenses just for turning up.
Hey, Gazza,
we should have been MEPs.
Strike of luck we won that 50 million, eh, Kev?
Oh, I wonder who's doing our jobs now.
Probably someone charging after price.
Lucky we got out when we did.
Your chance to win £50 million. With a guaranteed £50,000 to the player who gets the furthest. It's free to enter. You just have to pick the outcome of each game. Sign up for free at 50million.uk.
It's the invincible arrogance of Europe's elites that gets me. These are people who have seen the euro collapse. These are people who are presiding over a migration crisis on their borders. And yet, do they ever acknowledge that they need to change? No. They say they need more integration, more of our money, more control over this country. I think it's time that we said to people who are incapable of acknowledging that they've ever got anything wrong, I'm sorry, you've had your day. Unelected, unaccountable elites, I'm afraid, it's time to say you're fired. We're going to take back control.
Thank you, Lord High Chancellor.
We're here in Strasbourg to witness one of the most absurd examples of EU waste. The monthly move of EU Parliament from Brussels to Strasbourg. 4 days every month, the EU Parliament literally packs up its bags with thousands of bureaucrats, officials and translators, and thousands of boxes of paperwork transported 300 miles to this lavish building and is empty more than 300 days of the year. It's estimated that 5,000 people arrive for the four-day parliamentary meetings. A private firm is hired to move these thousands of boxes of paperwork from Strasbourg to Brussels every month. These are the trucks that are going to be packed full of paperwork. They're just arriving now to be loaded and taking the four-hour journey back to Brussels. Look at the size of that. Nothing inside it. They are... You're not allowed to film, apparently. Can you see that? She's telling us not to film. Okay, all right. Okay, thank you.
Is there a reason? Je
sais pas. On arrête de filmer.
So we've just been asked to move on. Everyone seems really tetchy that we're filming empty lorries. Now, why would they be upset about that? And the cost of this move? Well, it's a lot. Some figures put it at £130 million a year. That's £50 million spent on building maintenance alone. In total, this farce cost nearly £2 billion since it started. With all these lorries, cars, trains and planes, what does this mean to the environment? Well, for an EU obsessed with climate change, embarrassingly, this move creates over 10,000 tonnes of CO2, which is equivalent to 12,000 cars driving around the globe. So why do we have these moves every month? Well, Strasbourg is the official seat of the EU Parliament, as bound by a treaty. And in order to change that treaty, all 28 member states need to agree. So France veto any changes. And they do this not just to seem more important in the EU, but because the vast sums of money these moves bring to this region every month. So we're traveling through France, following a convoy of lorries on their way to Brussels. This is a great visible example of EU waste. Lorries driving back and forth. One can only imagine the unseen waste that goes on within the EU. Money that could probably be better spent elsewhere. If you ever needed an example of EU waste and how the EU can't be reformed, a real world example of where your money is actually going, then this is it. The idea of the Strasbourg Parliament was one of peace and reconciliation. Now, it's a symbol of EU waste and stupidity, demonstrating perfectly everything wrong with the EU. The money the EU spends moving this parliament could go towards providing more schools, or better supplies for our armed forces, or to your local NHS hospital. That's why you need to vote Leave on the 23rd of June.